Mastering.
Adaptive follow-ups for professors. Adaptive follow-ups are assignments given as a follow-up to a parent assignment. They provide additional coaching for each student, customized to each student's needs. If the textbook you use provides continuously adaptive learning, you can add a follow-up to existing assignments. You can also assign a follow-up in Step 5 of creating most assignments. If you see a message about the parent assignment when you tried to add a follow-up, consult the tips. For a follow-up to work well, the parent assignment must follow the tips. Here are some of them. The parent should include mostly publisher-created items from your textbook's current edition. The items each student sees in the follow-up are determined by knowledge graphs that plot the knowledge dependencies among items. Only current publisher items for your textbook are in the knowledge graph for your course. You can include other items in the parent assignment, but they won't add value to the follow-up. Consider what you want students to learn from the homework and the follow-up, and assign publisher items based on those goals. Finally, please remove any unused assignments from the course. Especially if you're using pre-built assignments, any extra unassigned assignments impact what gets recommended to students. Follow-ups look different from other assignments. Students see items in short question sets. Questions may be from the current chapter or from core prerequisites. Their answers in each set influence what items they'll be shown in the next set. Students who do well on all the topics they struggled with may get fewer than the maximum number of sets. Follow-ups belong to their own assignment category. Adaptive, with only 4 editable assignment grading settings. Length, the maximum number of sets any student will be given. Each set should take a student about 15 minutes. Total points, and whether the follow-up counts for practice, credit, or extra credit. We recommend credit or extra credit since students are motivated by points. Currently, you cannot mix 4 credit and extra credit assignments. All follow-ups must be one or the other. Due date, by default, 2 days after the parent assignment, and whether a student can test out of having to do the follow-up at all. We have heard from users that test out motivates students to work harder on the parent assignment. We recommend a test out score of at least 90%. Follow-ups reward honest work. In mastering, students who take hints and work through problems already get higher exam and final grades than students who don't work or who cheat. This effect is magnified by follow-ups. Students who know the material can test out. Students who have difficulty receive customized coaching and don't fall behind. Students who don't work have to do more on the follow-ups, and students using someone else's work lose the benefit of customized follow-ups entirely. They fall behind, have to work harder and longer on subsequent follow-ups, and get less back. For a view of how follow-ups look to students and how they're graded, see the follow-up video for students. For more information, see the follow-up tutorials and the online help.